Thank you. We'd like to welcome back to the bandstand Ms. Dinah Washington.
There was one here where she is one of her blonde pictures.
All of me.
Yeah, in full mink.
Why not take all of me?
And this is at a recording session, you know.
Can't you see?
One day she decided that she wanted to be a blonde, so she bought a blonde wig and became one. Gentlemen prefer blonde.
There was only one dime.
How can I?
She was the most outrageous one of the bunch.
You.
And that's being pretty outrageous.
Took the part that once was my heart.
She was the queen of the hand in your face. Like, she just did not care.
Come and get the rest of me.
Some people say she had 8 husbands. Some people say 9. I lost count. She was a pistol. I've never met anybody like her. My mother, Miss Dinah.
My sister loved her furs. She even had a mink toilet seat.
This was at the Newport Jazz Festival. 1958 brought the house down because, of course, nobody knew that Dinah could play the vibes. She was a marvelous piano player.
I said, first of all, I understand you torture all the piano players. He said, play so-and-so, bitch. And I said, play so-and-so, bitch. I said, well, play it yourself, bitch. You're supposed to be a piano player.
She could be evil. Yes, she could.
Well, Dinah, you've been called the queen of the blues, but you've also been called the queen of the jukeboxes. Do you think that both of those names are flattering to you?
Well, you should hear some of the other names I've been called.
If she had cursed somebody out, then the publicity was bad. If they were reviewing her music, then it was almost always good. She was such a wonderful singer, and it was nothing that she couldn't sing.
Well, your goodbye left me with eyes that cry.
There's something about her voice that puts it on sort of a cutting edge. There's a, like, don't you mess with me. Wonderful.
Why don't you rush back and support the rest? Come on, baby. Come on, daddy, and get all of me. Yeah. Come on, baby. Come on, daddy, and get all of me.
You couldn't categorize Dinah. You couldn't put her in, you know, in a box. She was a jazz singer, she was a blues singer, she was a pop singer, she was all of those. And, of course, she started out as a gospel singer.
She didn't talk a lot about her childhood. Every once in a while, we'd get little bits and pieces, like when she was small, she would tell my mother, I want to be a showgirl. That's what she told my mother when she was real little.
She is a migrant from the South, part of the largest mass migration of African Americans. She embodies that kind of Southern background, but also this sense of modernity and the urban.
I've got a dime in my pocket and a long, long way to go.
They have this sense of defiance, this sense of we're a new generation, and we're going to lay the groundwork for what will become known as the Civil Rights Movement.
Tell me, baby, have you any...
Boy, this really brings back old memories. The church was right here. My grandmother and my mother attended the church often. My mom started singing here at St. Luke's as a little girl, and she was married here. Also, her funeral was here. And as I look around, this bring back a lot of old memories.
Mother was a choir director when she was in Alabama, and she played at different churches in Chicago. My sister went along with her. I was always amazed at how well Dinah played.
God bless your hearts, giving honor to the Lord and to the Lord.
My grandmother, if you didn't go to church, you'd hear about it for the next 2 weeks.
It was very simple. After going to church, we'd come home and eat and go to another church. We wouldn't get home till 10, 11 o'clock at night, from church, church, church. My grandmother was the strongest woman I've ever seen, and my mother, so clang, battles.
This is Dinah and her mother at a recording session. And obviously, Dinah was playing the piano. Her mother was singing in the background. I guess with her habits, she felt that she couldn't do a gospel album, get away with it. But I'm sure she could have and done wonders.
With inspiration, I wanna be loved starting tonight.
Dinah is one of the most soulful singers that I've ever heard. She's soulful before soul music. It's always a sort of place in her voice that's like home. You know, it's the place to which she always returns, I think.
Until I tingle.
She sits at the very beginning of a lineage where we'd see the emergence of someone like Aretha Franklin, who absolutely loved Dinah Washington.
Wrong or right.
My grandmother wanted her to stay in church and sing. And my mother, she would go and sneak out with my uncle, Andrew Tibbs. He was a singer also. And they would sneak out to the Southside clubs and sing. And they would get home before my grandmother would wake up.
I'm an evil gal. Don't you bother with me. Yes, I'm an evil gal.
Eventually, someone told my grandmother, and she was furious.
The people who had money during those times were numbers runners, black gangsters, with their contingent. She grew up in those neighborhoods and with those people. And so those people connected with her, and she enjoyed performing for them.
Men in the east, men in the west, but my man here in Harlem always loves me the best. I'm an evil gal.
When I think about her singing Evil Gal Blues, that was her. I mean, when she and my mother would get angry at each other, I was afraid of both of them.
If you want to be happy,
long before I was born, my mother had won a talent show right here at the Regal. It was a really big moment. My grandmother didn't like it at all because she knew the outcome. She knew she would stop going to church and pick up all the bad habits in the streets and start drinking and hanging out. And my grandmother was definitely right, but, you know, it didn't happen all the time, you know, but mostly it was business. The voice like that, you couldn't hold her back.
I'm a slick chick on a solid kick. Always looking ready, man, I'm on the mellow side.
She loved Bessie Smith. She loved Billie Holiday. Those were two of her idols, and you could tell it in her singing if you listened to her real good.
Now when I start to jive in, we need the groovy move.
Prior to her becoming Dinah Washington, she was Little Ruth Jones.
It was a club owner in Chicago who told her that she had a lot of talent, but that her real name, Ruth Jones, just wasn't going to cut it. She needed something, as he put it, that rolled off the tongue like rich liquor. And he came up with Dinah Washington.
Hello, honey. I don't believe I caught the name.
Oh, I forgot to tell you, I'm Dinah Washington.
Oh, Dinah Washington.
In 1942, Dinah started her career as an 18-year-old kid on a bus full of men, the Lionel Hampton Band, the only girl on the bus.
It was a swinging band. People would be fighting each other to try to get into the ballroom where we were playing. She was still a young girl coming from a church choir, so there were a lot of things she didn't know about makeup and clothing and the way she dressed and so forth. The guys in the band would say, geez, why would she wear something like that?
Racism was a very blatant part of the everyday living experience. It was a rough time for musicians, and especially for a young black woman.
You drove down the highway and you had to figure out a way we can drive this far because we know there's going to be a boarding house where we can stay. We know there's a gas station where we can get gas. We know there's a place that will serve us, but we have to go to the back door. Things that white Americans never had to think twice about.
Hey, what are you doing after the show?
You haven't even asked me what I'm going to do on the show.
Oh, I see. Well, whatever it is, who's complaining? But tell us about it, Dinah.
Oh. Anyway, I came here to sing a brand new ballad, Million Dollar Smile.
Million Dollar Smile.